All right, welcome to Next Lesson for Ancient Greece. In the last one, we basically just went way into the mythological story of King Minos, the Minotaur, and Theseus. I shouldn't say way into it. I gave you a brief summary, but it was a bit of a long video. And just recap that one again. It's all about the moral of the story, or what we pull out of it. You know, what stories last for a long time? Why do we continue to tell certain stories? What do we want to pull from it? How do we want it to affect our society today? Anyways, in this lesson, we're going to just basically finish off talking about the Minoans and then talk about how they disappear. Well, we have no clue, so we'll talk about the theories of how they disappear. So, something I probably should have shown last lesson was these pictures. So, what you're looking at here is Knossos, or the Palace of Knossos. At least on the left-hand side, you're seeing the ruins. On the top right-hand corner, you're seeing an artist depiction of what it looked like back in the day. And then the bottom right is a picture, a more close-up picture of the ruins of the Palace of Knossos. And this is definitely a place that's on my bucket list. I still have not taken like an Aegean cruise yet to go see all these ancient Greek sites, or a Mediterranean cruise. Again, one of those things I hope to do sometime in the near future. We'll see. Anyways, after that whole story, if you just watched that last lesson and we talked about the Minotaur, and then you get to the part about the labyrinth and, you know, creating this thing where it's really hard to get out of, and then we go back to one of the earlier things we talked about in the first lesson, or in other units as well, is just how we have stories today, tall tales, mythological tales, to where, you know, there's no way that happened. There's no way it's really hard to believe that those things happened. But then you look at something like this, is like, well, I can see how a story from that building turned into the labyrinth story, or the Minotaur story over time, along with the lives of the people that lived there, you know. Definitely exaggerated, but now it comes down to what was the real story, because it looks like there's definitely some edifice there that you could say, well, that most likely was the labyrinth. So anyways, you know, you could easily get lost in that thing, basically. Now, this is where I liked, and again, I probably should have showed you this earlier as well. These are frescoes, more frescoes that lets us know more about the life of the Minoans, you know, their society and things like that. Top left-hand corner, very famous fresco from the Minoans. Like, I don't think I've ever seen a book, documentary, or anything that, when talking about the early Greek civilizations, that doesn't show that one of the guy basically doing what looks like a cartwheel over a running bull. You know, is this a game? Is this like a sport? I'm not really sure, but it kind of seems like one. Kind of a crazy deal. Then the whole focus in the focus with the Minoans on being sea traders, and why Poseidon would be their god, you know, the nice fresco of sea life, essentially, and the dolphins. Then the bottom is interesting because you actually find that particular photo and actually a lot of, how do I put this, like hair textbooks, cosmetology textbooks. Even going to this idea that even hairstyles we have today are influenced by history. You know, like those hairstyles right there, is like, how do the Minoans do that? Let's try to do that ourselves. Things like that. Of course, when it gets to cosmetology or hair, whatever, I don't know what you call this, hair design. Yeah, there's a lot you can pull from so many different cultures in the world. There's a lot to go off of there. Those textbooks are massive. If anybody's thinking of going that route in life, now, there's a lot to learn there, a lot of history to learn there. But that's one of the things you'll see in those books. And again, it lets us know a little bit more about their society and what they're like. Now, getting into the disappearance of the Minoans. So, notice I have here with an island called the Island of Santorini. This island is, I forget how far, 50, 100 miles north of Crete, something like that, maybe closer. No one really knows what happens to the Minoans. It feels like they were there at one point, and then it's just, they're gone. They're just gone. Like the Mycenaeans actually come down and re-inhabit all their places. You know, what would have gotten them to leave, or what might have destroyed them? Because there's not much evidence of, like, there's not mass burial grounds, there's not massive, there's not battlefields with dead bodies everywhere, that type of thing, at least that I know of. You know, why did these people go bye-bye? Why did this massive great civilization just disappear? Well, I'm not going to go into all the different theories, but the most likely theory that I have heard and I have read about is basically of, you could say, like almost a super volcano. Maybe not the Yellowstone super volcano, but a big, huge explosion, a volcanic explosion on this island of Santorini. If you're looking at that picture, that thing in the middle that's underwater there, that's an underwater volcano. I'm not sure if it's still active or if it's dormant now, if it's a dead volcano, but that used to be a whole island right there. You can kind of tell by looking at it that it was blown out, that whole island just blew up. It's a very small island. If you can kind of tell, there's an airfield on the right-hand side there, you know, for tourists to come down and see things. I believe there's still some ruins, some ancient Greek ruins on that island as well. Anyways, but this island blew up. And it said that there's even records from ancient Egypt that says that, you know, the sky was darkened for a day or 3 days or something like that, where you couldn't even see your hand in front of your face, you know, most likely because of an ash cloud about the same time that this volcanic explosion went off. This volcanic explosion, then, if something is that big, you know, something like a Mount St. Helens, or I can't remember the mountain, but out in Iceland, the same thing happened out in Iceland. What was it, like 2007, 2008? I cannot remember now. Basically, gigantic volcanic explosions. Mount St. Helens is the big one for us here in the United States. this will cause things like acid rain. You'll get huge earthquakes that will then cause tsunamis. You know, if you're an island nation, yeah, that could be the perfect storm that might get you. If you survive all that, just decide, the gods hate us. Time to go. Let's get on whatever boat we can or make a boat and let's just leave. And that really is just, I was going to bring this picture up. That, by the way, that's a picture of Mount St. Helens blowing its top. Pretty huge. And it said that this explosion on the island of Santorini, which, by the way, was known as Thera, T-H-E-R-A, well, I spelled there, sorry. The island of Thera way back when. Santorini now, island of Thera way back when it blew up. That explosion of Thera was even bigger than Mount St. Helens, and that's saying something. So that's the best theory there is to why they went bye-bye. But in the end, we just don't know. So that's the Minoans for you. There's a little bit more we could go into, but we're pretty much finished as far as the class is concerned, with the Minoans at least. And in the next lesson, we'll start off with the second major early Greek civilization, and that is the Mycenaeans.